Are you struggling to keep your projects organized so that your organization knows everything that's going on? Well, if so, this video is for you because we're going to be breaking down this exact template inside of Softr.io. If you haven't used it before, Softr is a no-code front-end application that's going to allow you to build whatever software you need without needing to know a single line of code. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Now, at the forefront of these tools is Softr.io, and that is exactly what we're going to be talking about here today as we break down a template example. But before we get into it, I want to invite you to join me for some automation training. The true power of no-code comes in automating repetitive tasks, and it doesn't matter what software you're using, automation is going to increase your efficiency to the next level. I break down how to get started and all the fundamental components of no-code automation in our training, so check that out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I will share the link for that directly below this video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen here, and I invite you to follow along with me to install this template. In addition to the link for our webinar, you can also find the link to this template in the notes and details of this video. So once you find the link to that, you are going to be starting with the template of project management that has already been created inside of Softr. Now, before we install any new template in Softr, I always like to first get an understanding of what it is we're putting together. And so here on the right-hand side, we can actually scroll through some different pieces. So number one, we see here from this image that we've got a sign-in page. And this is great for any kind of software that we're building that is internal to our team because, of course, we want to make sure that it's eyes only. We only want certain people to be able to access this information. So, of course, a login page with email and password at a minimum is exactly what the doctor ordered. Now, we can scroll on down and look at some other pictures here. We also see that we've got a projects list breakdown. We also then are able to edit records. So if you don't already know, once you're inside of Softr, you can actually edit information that's accessed in your portal. We can also drill in to add new projects, check out our tasks, look at things on a Kanban view and a calendar, as well as access our team directory, etc. So this is the overall functionality of this application that we're going to install. Let's go ahead and get started. The next thing we want to do is come to the bottom here and say use template. Now the best part about Softr's templates is that not only do they include the front-end application that we'll actually be accessing, but they also allow us to import or copy the actual back-end components as well. Where are we going to actually store this information? It's not actually in the front-end that Softr provides, but we're going to store that information in a back-end solution, in this case, Airtable. So let's go ahead and use the template here, select here, and the next part is we have to find our Airtable API key. Now, if you've never done this before, simply go to airtable.com and log in. In the upper right-hand corner of your screen, you'll be able to select your account. Now, once you open up your account, you're going to be taken to the developer hub right here where you see API. So we can go to the developer hub and we're going to have access to our existing API keys. If you need to create a new API key, you can do so here. Don't share this key with anyone. It is like secret backdoor tunnel information into your Airtable software. So this is only something you want to share with other software, specifically Softr.io in this case, that will be talking with your data in Airtable. So let's go ahead and copy out our key, flip on back to Softr, and paste it right back into the API key section. Then we are automatically taken to the next step, which is we are going to copy this backend data structure. So let's copy the base to our account. Simply by clicking here, it's going to ask us where we want to install this base. We can install it wherever we would like. In this case, I'll drop into this place called New Test, and I'll add the base. So now that we're all set up here, the base is actually being imported or copied into our Airtable system. Here we can see the actual structure of data that we're looking at. So we have the projects listed out here, the tasks as they pertain to projects and people in charge of those tasks. We also have a team table where we actually see the different team members and their respective roles. We can then look at the projects as well. So these are the comments within the projects. And then we can also track the comments within the tasks. So for both of these things, we're gonna see this in play inside of our Softr front end. Now that we've copied this on over, let's flip back now into our Softr account and let it know that we've created the application. So yes, we installed this, the new project management by Softr. Let's go ahead and create the front end, which is the Softr perspective of this. This is linking back to the live data that we just imported into our Airtable base, and now we're able to access the front end through Softr. Now, this has taken at this point up to maybe 5 minutes. All we've done is copied the backend data schema and then also copied the template for the front end inside of Softr. So now it's time for us to get an understanding of what we're looking at here. Now, one thing that might draw your attention when you first find Softr is that some of this information looks a bit redundant. There's actually a reason behind this. Here we have two different headers. And if we click on one of these headers, we can actually see the rules that apply to the visibility. Here on the right-hand side of my screen, you see visibility. I can drill in here and see who has access to see this header. And so this header is only visible to logged in users of the employee group. Conversely, if I look at my second header here and I drill into the visibility here, you'll see that this is available to logged in users of the manager group. So while it looks like we have some redundant information here, and in a way we do, in fact, from the user experience, nothing is redundant. There is only one header that will be visible, either to employees or to managers. So essentially what we're getting at here is the visualization of the web app, the experience of the app in general, is highly customized based on the user type who's logged in. And so if I were an employee, I'm getting that top view, which allows me to look at my projects, my tasks, my Kanban, my calendar view, and then takes me to team. The second header here, you'll notice is different because it also has this capability here where I can add a project. And so the managers have the capability to also add projects to the overall data schema. However, employees do not. They can only track existing information. So in this way, we're showcasing the flexibility of Softr that says, hey, I've got one application, but depending on who you are and who's logged in, your experience is going to be completely different. And so whenever you're curious about why you might have one or two or three different instances of a similar variable or block, always check the visibility, as I've shown you here, to make sure that this is actually only visible to one member group at a time. In this case, managers, in the other case, employees. Now, if you're ever curious about establishing these groups, on the left-hand side of our screen, we can drill into users to get an idea about how this is all set up. Now you'll see that by default, this is connected to team. And if you recall, if we flip back to our Airtable schema here, we have a table called team. And so effectively, the users in Softr are going to be stored here in our Airtable base, and we're going to look up the role of every single user when they log in. So Softr knows, are they a manager or are they an employee? All based on this dropdown right here that's selected for the various roles inside of our Airtable system. So flipping back into Softr, how do we then actually determine what these groups are? Well, this is all handled inside of the user groups section. This is a recent adjustment to Softr's setup. So if you are accustomed to the older version of Softr, this might throw you for a bit of a loop. So make sure to explore this new feature within Softr. It's just relocating the old groups. So if we click on user groups here, you can see the different types of groupings that we can assign as we're working through our different modals. As you saw earlier, we assigned them to specific groups. The employee group exists here, the manager group exists here, and of course we have logged in users and then all users as well. These are kind of default groups, the logged in users and the all users. But we can add additional user groups as well, and we can establish whatever different rules we want to set up for this. So we could add, for example, a new user group name saying just Gareth if I wanted to. So anybody by the name of Gareth, I could say. So I could come in and say, well, I'm gonna add a condition that the logged in user's first name must be, is Gareth. So just that simply, I've created a new user group that pertains to anybody in my system that shares my first name. Now, I don't know why you'd want that one per se, but just as an example, you can establish whatever different rules you are inclined to establish that group people differently so that they experience the web application in a different and unique way. Once you're happy with that, say create user group. You can add additional conditions as well, but for this example, I will exit out. So here we are, we see that there are specific pages after sign up. So after a manager signs in, then we can take them to a specific place within our app. And then also after they sign out of our app, we can take them to a specific place. Maybe they go back to the login page, for example. We could set all these rules up so that whenever anybody in this group signs in or signs out, they experience that functionality in the application. Now to move forward, we're gonna look at the other pages inside of our application. So let's click on over to pages and get an idea of what's going on here. We can start with my profile. A lot of these are kind of templated different modals that might be added into pretty much any app that requires people to sign in. So here we have the sign-in information, so we have people coming in and changing their password, for example. Or additionally, we might have something like forgot password. So on this particular instance, we have a, hey, if I can't remember my password and I need to log in, I can go here, put in my email, and you're gonna send me my password. All of this is already baked into Softr, which makes implementing these templates way easier. But just as an example, you have all these different modals already put together. Now for the actual core functionality of this particular application, let's drill into the first step, which is really the projects. We can come into projects. We can take a look here, by the way, on pages, and we see this little locked icon. This suggests to us that it's only available to logged in users. Nobody else can access this unless they've already logged into our application. Now once we're in here, we can see actually who is in charge of this account, all of the associated projects, etc. So we have a lot of information that is obviously private to our organization, and this is going to be completely dependent upon what you have inside of your Airtable database. Again, as you add new projects, as you add new tasks, all of that information will show up in Airtable, but it will be nicely organized and clearly visual to your team in your Softr application. Now, in order to preview this app, we first have to create passwords for these people, these fake accounts, so that we can preview it on behalf of a manager or on behalf of an employee. So let's head back to our users and actually get that set up. Now, we have these two users here, and we can go ahead and add new users either manually or by importing. And we can also decide to create magic links. This is perhaps the easiest way for us to log in and impersonate somebody, but also if we take any action inside the app, it will take that action on behalf of the person that we are logged in as. For the sake of simplicity here, I'm just gonna generate a magic link for Michelle, who is an employee inside of our organization. By clicking there, I've created that link, but before I can actually use it, I have to first publish the application. So in the upper right corner, let's publish it. And once we've published the app, we get the confetti on the screen. And now lastly, we can pop back in here and access that magic link. Let's go ahead and copy the link, open up a new window and paste it in, and go ahead and access it. Inside here, we are now logged in as Michelle, who is an employee. We can tell that we are Michelle because if we hover over here and look at my profile, we can actually go to the team setup here where Michelle can update her information, include an avatar, change her password, etc. As you see, this is all pre-baked into the template, but also Michelle can flip into projects to see what's going on. She can look at the different projects in the team right here. Maybe she wants to drill into one of these, the website audit version 2. She can click into that and get a dialed in version on what's happening here, the total cost of the project, the date of the project, and also who has been assigned to that project. So pretty cool stuff. Of course, we can navigate those projects, but also add tasks to ourselves and create new tasks to help make sure that everyone is up to date on what has to be occurring inside of this. So here we are, different tasks that have been assigned to Michelle here that she can review, drill into, and check out where she is in the process of completing these different tasks. This is assigned to Michelle. There can be some discussion and comments that happen here. We can just leave a quick note here, comments, add that comment, and that's gonna show up here at the bottom, tagged by Michelle at the date and time that she entered that comment. So this is a great way for people to collaborate inside of the web app and further the initiative of the company, which is moving these projects forward. Now, lastly, we can flip over to the Kanban and the calendar views here. Let's take a look at these one at a time. Kanban just allows Michelle to see all the different things, all of her different tasks in terms of status. And she can also update these and mark them as complete or move them back to in progress, etc. Also on the calendar view, Michelle can take a look at all of her tasks in terms of due dates on a calendar. So either way, she's getting exactly the information she needs to stay on task, to make sure that everything gets moved forward appropriately. The last component here is the team component. And of course, Michelle can access the overall team, check out phone numbers, check out email addresses for anyone in her organization to keep everything on track and moving forward. I know we covered a lot here, but hey, there's a lot of information to unpack in this template. So I invite you again to check the link below this video and get set up here for yourself. Of course, please know that you can make any changes you would like to your instance once you've copied that template over, and cultivate that experience so that it's exactly what your team needs. That's it for this video. If you want to see more information like this on no code and no code news, be sure you've subscribed to this channel. And in the meantime, let's keep on building. So, one more time. Oh, down here. I don't know where we go. Hold on.